Hello, everybody, and welcome. You are watching the EuroLeague Women Game Day 10 Group A. Fenerbahce Alagoz against Casademont Zaragoza here in the Istanbul Metro Energy Sports Hall. Well, there will be no shortage of energy for this one. You better believe it. Fenerbahce coming off a loss last week, and Zaragoza going for a seventh consecutive win. Also, you can see the other games going on in the group this week, and some big ones: Asvel at Valencia Basket, DVTK on third, still within striking distance of first place, going up against Beretta Famalicchio. But games need to be won first and foremost to get into the postseason, and to do that, you need to collect as many as possible. I think it's safe to say you can rule out definitely Setsisik and Polski, but the race for the top spots, Beretta Famalicchio, seems like they always start to get it going at the right time. But our focus is on a game between two teams that had a real barn burner in the first meeting in Spain, a game that was won by just 3 points by Fenerbahce, the defending champions of the EuroLeague women. Zaragoza have had a lot of close calls this season. They've had some tough defeats. That was a tough defeat. They lost to DVTK. That was a tough defeat. But as I said, they've won 6 games in a row. And can they keep the momentum going? Well, it couldn't come at a tougher place to do that. But then again, wouldn't you like to be riding a long winning streak full of confidence when you go up against the best? You know, you're probably not going to sneak up on Fenerbahce, especially because of how well you played in that first game, both teams. And Fenerbahce, though, you just have to wonder if Zaragoza are happy to be facing them after they suffer their first defeat of the season. Fenerbahce, again, up at the top of the standings at 8-1. DVTK on Therm and Casademont Zaragoza follow at 7-2. Beretta Famalicchio 6-3. So realistically, Valencia Basket still in the hunt for that top four spot. And right now, if you're Zaragoza, hey, it's your first year in the EuroLeague women. It's been a fantastic season and everything is good. In many senses, there's no pressure. The only pressure that you feel in this situation is the pressure that you put on yourselves, and they've already navigated some difficult waters to get to this point where they are. And again, they were close the first time they played Fenerbahce at home, and I think now they're a much more confident team coming into this one, and there's no shortage of players that have that great, that play at that high level for Zaragoza, who have every reason to believe they could come out and get the win tonight. So Fenerbahce, it's no secret, you know, Natasha Howard, Emma Messemann, arguably the greatest European player in the game today, and arguably the greatest women's player of all time? Question mark, I'll let you decide. She's already in that conversation. That's how good she is. And I think winning last season's EuroLeague Women, one of many, and also getting that FIBA Women's Eurobasket crown, that first one with Belgium, has put her in the conversation. So they have got a tough team. Kayla McBride, I wouldn't say that Fenerbahce are stacked, but their elite players are so good that any one of them on their day can just be superstars and come out and really undermine you. But it didn't work last week for them against Asvel. Those players had good games, but they still fell to Asvel. So that was their first defeat as well. Now back to the friendly confines of the Alagoz Holding Arena, the Metro Sports Energy Arena, and a game against Zaragoza. Zaragoza wearing their traditional garnet red tonight on the left, and Fenerbahce standing out right now with the yellow tops, and they'll be dressed out in the whites. So, what else can we say about this game? Coming in, Fenerbahce leading the way for them this season in scoring. Collier at 20 points per game. But Messamon at 17.4 points and 5.2 assists, really their star player. Cyprian Stoica, Paulina, Carolina Gazdos, and Silvia Marziali, the referees for this game. Valerie Garnier, also the coach of Fenerbahce, one of the most successful when you consider what she's been able to do at the helm of clubs, especially France, getting to the podium on so many occasions. Mariona Ortiz, Micaela Denali-Pivet, Alexa Gulba, Leonie Fibisch, and Serena Lynn Geldof starting tonight for Casademont. And you wonder if that's because Geldof and Messamon are teammates in that Belgium national team. Carlos Quintero also has Holyshinska, Gemino, La Corzana, Hermosa, Atkinson. He's got a lot of weapons at his disposal. And there he is, Carlos Cantero. And then the starting five tonight for Fenerbahce, I should have said Yvonne Anderson as well. I mean, this is a star-studded team. Sevgi Uzun, Howard, Messamon, Yvonne Anderson, all stars in their own right. Kayla McBride, Lekovic, we haven't seen her play much, surprisingly. Laksa, she will get big minutes. Lekovic, one of the outstanding players at the Eurobasket women last season, or last summer, or this past summer, shall we say, playing for Montenegro, and truly set the Eurobasket women alight in Israel, and also played in when her team made it to Ljubljana. So a lot of good young talent, a lot of big name talent, and a lot at stake in this game. You could say similar for both teams. Is it crucial for Fenerbahce to get first place? I think it's probably pretty important for them to have that veneer of near invincibility. We already know they're not invincible because they lost last time out. But I think it's important from their standpoint to bounce back and not let any doubt creep into their minds about how good they are, because everybody knows how good this Fenerbahce team is, or at least how good they should be. And Valerie Garnier, I'm sure with all of her experience, is the right person for this job, stabilizing things after that defeat. And for Zaragoza again, they are playing just terrific basketball. They're on the road, and they've got nothing to lose. The only thing is they don't want to start losing games and fall out of the top four. So, but this would have been a game that anybody would have said before the season going in, they would have no chance. I don't think anybody would have envisioned Zaragoza being 7-2 coming in, having lost to Fenerbahce in their first game by 3 points as a potential winner in this game. But look at Messamon, who is the heart and soul captain. You can see she is ready to go. So Camille Albert is actually going to be apparently serving as the head coach tonight. Not sure if that's right or not. We'll see. She's definitely the assistant. Doesn't matter. These are the players. These are the people that are going to decide things on the court. Geldof, what a great opportunity for her to start. She will be jumping center against Howard, and we are ready to rumble. Well, We're underway, folks, here in Istanbul, and Fenerbahce race down the layup after the opening tip. Messaman passes to McBride for the first bucket of the game. Ortiz, just so slick, such a wonderful player to watch. She's got the ball right now. She's calling the plays. It's great seeing her in the EuroLeague women in this first ever season for Zaragoza in the EuroLeague women. And look at that. She comes right out, calmly makes the reverse layup with that left hand. Now the dump down low to Messaman. She banks it in. Gulba hands it off. Putting it up from deep is Gulba, the Latvian international, but it doesn't drop. Messaman again. Geldof has to respect her passing. Howard going to work. Gets blocked by Geldof. How about that? Geldof with a swat. Gulba again, feet set, and puts it up and misses again. And the ball knocked out of Kayla McBride's hands and into the hands of the opposition. So good defense by Zaragoza. Now the pass down low, and going up and scoring is Leoni Fibish. You can already attach the word superstar to her name. The German international. And here she is, almost. Ortiz got a hand on it. They couldn't get the steal. Shot clock winding down. Messaman has to settle for the jump shot. Now racing to the other end is Zaragoza. And nobody picks up Mikaela Denali Pivets. And likewise, nobody picks up Sevgi Uzun. So both teams taking what the defense gives them. Von Anderson called for a foul. She's going to walk over to the bench, come out of the game. I almost wonder if there's something wrong with her, because she raised her hand immediately as if to say, I committed the foul, and then she started to leave the game. So Alperi Onar comes in. Zaragoza do not turn it over. Fibish gets it back down low. Ortiz misses. And Howard with another rebound. McBride missing from the corner. Geldof rebounds. And the pass over the outstretched hands of Fibish, and racing down the floor is Onar, who just checked in the game and gets her first bucket. So the reason why Valerie Garnier is not here as we look at the replay is her father sadly passed away this week. So she is not at the game. So our condolences go to Valerie Garnier. Our thoughts are with her. Far more important things on her mind right now than basketball. Here's Kayla McBride putting it up, and first real mistake of the game by Zaragoza, fouling the jump shooter. That's one of the cardinal sins. You are not supposed to foul the jump shooter. You can certainly understand why you would want to guard this player, though. She's one of the premier scorers in Europe, has been for some time, playing in the EuroLeague women. Goes to the line, makes the first. Their overall efficiency is what's been so impressive, which takes into account all of her contributions. She's third on the team at 20.8 behind Collier and Messamon. Collier not here now. And a wonderful pass, and Geldof scores. Boy, what a thrill this must be for her, getting the start against Messamon and coming out and delivering. And you know there's people in Belgium watching this game, and they must be excited not just to watch Emma play, but to watch Sarah Lynn go at it and have some success. We saw her have a block, and she does not complete the three-point play, but she has tied it at 10. The Belgian women have so many fans everywhere for their style of basketball, that's for sure. Here's McBride. Messamon, turn around. Wow. I mean, you were just watching a legend in action. It is just a thrill every time she walks onto a court to watch Emma Messamon play. Whether you're in the arena or watching on TV, three does not drop. That was Gulba. Can't get a bucket right now, but it doesn't matter because Fenerbahce don't score, so they got a chance maybe to make a three. Nope. Phoebus passes it down low, and Geldof's attempt this time does not drop, but that's the right play. Phoebus is just sensational in terms of just kind of easing her way into games. She's the headline player in that team, but she lets the game come to her. Her other teammate, you know, her teammates rather, all get involved. You know, much of that onus is on Ortiz as the playmaker to get everybody going. Oh, and Ortiz this time misread Phoebus. Ball goes out of bounds, and we're going to have some substitutions with 4.5 minutes remaining, and Fenerbahce leading it 12-10. So this is a big game for Camille Aubert, who coaching in place of Garnier, clearly up to it. Here is Kayla McBride, and talking about big-time shooters. She just serves up a little reminder. 15-10, Fenerbahce on top. Now, going the other way for Zaragoza. Atkinson has checked into the game, and Geldof misses from the baseline. And the tempo quickening a little bit here for Fenerbahce. Free throws coming. Senurek, Big Turkey Center. There's Camille Aubert. So Geldof goes out, and Hermosa, the promising youngster, young Spanish international, checks into the game. Give Uzun the assist after that made free throw, and Onar gets a second to go as well. And Fenerbahce extending their biggest lead of the game here. It can happen in a flash with this Fenerbahce team. They can put a run on you in a hurry. Jimeno comes into the game. She misses it from deep. Vega Jimeno. Three-point shot is good from Uzun. And the Zaragoza must be thinking about getting a timeout. I mean, I'm almost surprised we didn't see one there. If they don't get a bucket here and Fenerbahce score, I think you could definitely expect a timeout. Jimeno passes it back to Ortiz. Ortiz has it taken away. It's going to be a layup. And Alperi Onar with the layup, and sure enough, with the 12-point lead, the timeout comes from the Zaragoza bench. And it's Fenerbahce striking with these easy opportunities. Messaman already with 4 assists. Well, something you cannot afford to do if you want to upset the defending champs on their home court here in Istanbul is turn the basketball over. Zaragoza have done it 3 times, and it's led to 7 points for Fenerbahce. So they really do punish you when you turn it over. Holešinska is checking into the game, the Czech Republic international. Fenerbahce also with 8 fast break points. And Zaragoza need to start making some shots here. And they're facing some pressure as they bring the basketball up the floor. Holešinska wears number 2. Atkinson has it knocked out of her hands. Ooh. Well, she likes to pass it for a long 2, and Denali Pivic knocks it down. So that was a 2, not a 3. Remember Tom Hovest telling his players they weren't allowed to take those long 2s. They have to step behind the arc. Talking about when he coached Japan's national team, the women. McBride, meanwhile, comes down and knocks in another jumper. Holešinska. Shot clock winding down. Vega Jimeno. Oh, she can hit the 3, but she is not coming close yet. Messaman. Remember, Zaragoza have won 6 consecutive games. Fenerbahce, meanwhile, coming off their only loss of the season, and that was against Asvel. Holešinska pulls up on the break, misses. Jimeno, the rebound, gets it back to Holešinska. Petra Holešinska was electrifying at times for the Czech Republic at the FIBA Women's Eurobasket. Czech Republic, tough luck losers. Here is a pass up ahead, another fast break. Holešinska may be fortunate not to have the whistle blow. I thought they might call a foul there as she reached in, and Fenerbahce up by 14. Atkinson from the right. She drills it and makes it an 11-point game. And talk about desperate for points. Oh. Have they only given her a 2? Must have had a foot on the line, so that's a blow. That's 2 long 2s from the corners. Messaman goes in and just makes it even with the right hand on the reverse layup. Atkinson over to Holešinska. She drills the 3. Are they going to count it? If not, how unfortunate for Holešinska and Zaragoza. Pivet saying, count the basket. They're going to huddle up. They're going to talk about this. Are they going to count it? That's the question. No, I don't know what they're, I'm not sure what they're looking at here. head coach's challenge. Are they looking at this as a potential unsportsmanlike? They want to see if she trips her, I think. No. I'm getting dizzy watching all of this. Penetration kick. Didn't look like it was anything untoward. Yeah, they called it on Senurek. So I'm assuming they were looking at it as a potential upgrade to an unsportsmanlike, but with 2.4 seconds left, it could be that they were looking to see how much time should be on the clock as well. Romano drives in. Oh, boy. Got exactly what she wanted and then missed the shot. Tough quarter shooting for Jimeno. And at the end of one, Fenerbahce already on top, 28-14 against Casademont Zaragoza. Well, so far it's the Emma Messelman show. No surprise with all of her points, 6 points. She's got 3 rebounds. She's got 4 assists. She's got 1 steal. At plus 12, she and Sevgi Uzun are the two players with the highest efficiency. Kayla McBride is plus 10. She's leading the team in scoring with 9 points. Alpri Onar has 8. Uzun has 5 points along with 4 assists. And for Zaragoza, 4 points apiece for Pivets and Phoebish. So the only Phoebish probably kind of an ideal start to the game for Casademont Zaragoza. They were right there, but you could see that Fenerbahce just kind of flipped the switch and took it to another level to race into this big 14-point lead. And now checking into the game is Katia Laksa, their Latvian international. So Laksa, really good shooter. We'll have to keep an eye on her. Phoebish passes back outside to Ortiz. Gets it. Good play. Pass it around. And Holishinska didn't look comfortable taking that shot, but good job getting it back. Jimeno, she's got to back herself and still misses another one. So Jimeno 0-4, I think. And meanwhile, Kayla McBride just shows the quality and makes another 3. Mariona Ortiz, Jimeno now down low. Hermosa turns, and the referee's going to stop the clock because the shot clock buzzer sounded. So Jimenez 0-3 from 3-point range, not 0-4 from the floor. Fenerbahce fans coming out supporting the team today, this great club. Both men's and women's sports. Ooh. That was an interesting looking drive, and McBride knocks down another three-pointer. And stretches the lead to 20. Boy, Kayla McBride doing Kayla McBride things already. 3 of 4 from deep. She's got 15 points. Vega Jimeno finally gets one to go, and the coach stands by his player, and she delivers with her first 3 of the game. So Carlos Cantero has to be relieved that that one went in. Howard puts it up, and her high arcing 3 is no good. Well, it's a mountain to climb for Zaragoza. But there's only one thing to do. That's to get your pickaxe, get the climbing shoes, and start climbing. Here's Holyshinska driving in, and the contact on Howard sends Holyshinska to the free throw line. Nesamad comes back into the game. Holyshinska at the line. One of the Czechs that played college basketball in America, played at Illinois, and transferred to play at the University of North Carolina. So she got a good dose of big-time basketball in the Midwest. And then on the East Coast, the South, and the Southeast, and the ACC. Good job, Ortiz, coming up with the basketball. 15 points separating these two teams. Oh, beautiful bounce pass. Backdoor cut. Phoebus, though, has it knocked out of her hands by McBride. That was a great play. Great pass by Jimeno. Ortiz goes down, and Fenerbahce Messaman saves it in bounds. McBride up to Laksa, and she knocks down the 3, and we are seeing the might of Fenerbahce right now, folks. They are up 37-19. They are being relentless against Zaragoza, making shots, forcing turnovers. Even the hustle plays, when your best player hustles to save the ball before it goes out of bounds, that goes everywhere. Here she is getting a steal, passing it up to Laksa. Onar, now Messamine again, holds on to it, bounce pass. Senurik. Ortiz into the corner, and Jimeno hits her 2nd, and there's also a foul. Well, you really got to give Jimeno credit. I mean, yeah, she's been through this before. You can start a game cold, but you got to keep shooting. So she makes the three. And then a foul was called. So the foul was on Diallo, who's checked in, on Laxa. So here's Diallo. My goodness, hard to see what that was. Bessemer misses from deep. Atkinson has it. Here's Diallo. Turns. Made the move and then just did not control the basketball as she started to attack the rim. Ball just kind of slipped out. Messerman drives in, banks it in. 8 points for Emma Messerman. Four assists, three rebounds. 17-point advantage. Atkinson dumps it down low. Phoebish puts it up and in. We'll see. Phoebus play for Germany at the FIBA Women's Olympic Qualifying Tournament. An exciting time for German women's basketball. Messerman leans in and this time misses. Phoebus, the outlet to Ortiz. Under 4 minutes to go. Here's Diallo spinning, fades, and short. Laxa. Sinjarek has it knocked out of bounds by Phoebish. Seconds on the shot clock. Get in bounds and then a little runner, but misses everything. Atkinson. We'll be back in the game, number 10. Ortiz doesn't want the three. Back to Diallo. And Diallo rattles in the jump shot. And cuts it to a 13-point deficit. So another timeout has been called. Here's Diallo. Oh, boy. Very close to a moving screen there, but she scores. And the teams huddle up during this Fenerbahce timeout. Just as a reminder, no Valerie Garnier today, the head coach of Fenerbahce. Sadly, had her father pass away and is attending the funeral. So So Camille Aubert is here. Exactly sure who we were looking at there, but I'm assuming it might be a youth team. Asamad hands it off. It depends how long Messamon plays today, but there is missing everything. Messamon is not out of the realm of possibility that she could get a triple-double. But the fact that their lead now has been cut to 13 points, well, that means there's a little bit more work to do. And she should get a lot more minutes. Ortiz swings it. Atkinson. Ah, that's tough. Traveling. Fenerbahce, dangerously close to turning it over with Ortiz, pounding Sevgi Uzun. Here's Uzun, puts up a long two. And another opportunity for Zaragoza. And what's interesting to me about this game with Fenerbahce is they have not been ruthless so far. Atkinson scores. And Zaragoza closed the gap to 11. You know, great teams must be ruthless. They must put teams away when they get on top of them. Here's McBride. And the sheer quality of McBride right now is the biggest reason, in my opinion. Well, I guess you'd have to throw Messamon in there as well, that they have a 13-point lead. Atkinson cuts the deficit once again to 11. There's Messamon spinning, turning, getting to the baseline. Falls out of bounds. McBride is feeling it, folks. She is feeling it. What a magnificent performance. 20 points in the first half for Kayla McBride. And they lead it 44-30. Gulba. Gulba misses the layup. Messamon thinking about it. She puts up a long two and does not drop. So that's how it finishes the first half. Fenerbahce behind Kayla McBride is 20 points and Emma Messamon's 8 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists, and 8 points from Alpri Onar, as well as 5 points and 5 assists from Sevgi Uzun. They lead it 44-30 over Casademont Zaragoza. You see, Fenerbahce raced out to a 28-14 lead. And Casademont Zaragoza stabilized things well in that second quarter, but perhaps feel a little aggrieved that they aren't a little bit closer, but the brilliance of Kayla McBride in that late three stretched the lead back to 14. Here's a look back at some of the highlights and seeing how Kayla McBride got two of her points. Ortiz, always worth the price of admission. Messaman, definitely worth the price of admission, maybe even a little bit more. And Fetish as well. It was when Fenerbahce were able to get out and start running and capitalizing on some turnovers is when they really started to cause problems. So Zaragoza will need to cut out that stuff if they're going to want to have a chance of getting the win. Sevgi Uzun with that long jump shot. Pivots hitting the long jumper as well for Zaragoza. McBride, though, has been at her best tonight offensively. Kayla McBride, 4 of 5 from three-point range, 7 of 9 from the floor overall. She's made both of her free throws. She's even handed out a couple of assists. Many players will not get a plus 23 efficiency all season long in a game. McBride already has that in the first half tonight. Atkinson has brought a spark. She's got 6 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists. But it's the Kayla McBride show, folks. It's Fenerbahce up 44-30 at halftime. points by Fenerbahce, but today they really have gotten out and gotten on top of this Zaragoza team, leading by as many as 20 points. Zaragoza a couple of times looked like they're about to be run out of the gym, but they've been able to keep it relatively within striking distance. 44-30. Kayla McBride has been exceptional with her scoring. She has a game-high 20 points. Fenerbahce 11-19 inside the arc, 6 of 13 from deep, 4-4 at the line, and 4 of those three-pointers were made by her. Casademont actually out-rebounding Fenerbahce 16-13. Fenerbahce with three more assists. 4 assists for Messamon, 5 for Uzun. Remember, coming into this game, Fenerbahce up at the top of the group, but coming off their first loss of the season at 8-1. Zaragoza riding a 6-game winning streak. They are 7-2. So Group A right now is the domain of Fenerbahce, but it remains to be seen. DVTK also a game behind in second place. Second half is underway here in Istanbul, the city where East meets West. And Howard comes out and misses the first shot. Going off starting the second half just like she did in the first. Phoebish comes up and misses. Howard passes it back outside. Three is long, goes out of bounds. So no Helena Oma tonight. That's a big loss for Zaragoza. That's what happens during the season. You do have players that'll pick up injuries. Holyshinska starts and she turns it over. And that pass is intercepted. Terrific hustle back on defense. And Geldof does a good thing getting the ball to the guard. Ortiz. Pass down low. Geldof puts it up. Oh. That was Phoebish that had that steal, hustling back. Onar takes it all the way, drives in, puts it up and in. She's tough. I have to like how she plays the game. Ortiz. Guluba. Way overdue in terms of getting some points. She takes the bump from Howard and will go to the line. Howard reaching in, trying to take the ball away. Look at that. Well, still the team really with arguably nothing to lose coming into this game. Nobody expects them to win except them and their fans. Their fans expecting a big performance. They can play loose. And despite trailing by as many as 20 points, Casademont Zaragoza have done a good job of just kind of hanging around. But they're going to have to make a move here soon if they're going to seriously threaten an upset. Three-point look is short. Nobody boxes out as Senoret gets the offensive rebound and put back. Ortiz, I was just about to say she's so good with the basketball, but this time gets her pockets picked. Uzun goes in and just takes the lead up to 18, so some costly turnovers undermining Zaragoza's chances of a comeback. And called for the foul. She felt like she got all ball. Well, that pass was intended down low. And look at that. It worked out better for Zaragoza as Gulba makes the three. So she started the second half fast. Having failed to score in the first half, she's got 5 points here. Messaman drives in, looking for a foul, doesn't get it. Ibish swings it over to Holoshenska, who drills a three-pointer. And just like that, it's back to a 13-point game. This time, no whistle blew to wipe away the three for Holoshenska. And now the long three, no good. Rebound, Zaragoza, showing signs of life. Holoshenska has it taken away. That is dangerous proposition, dribbling in front of her, and it is costly. You simply cannot put the ball on the deck next to Alperi Onar. She's going to take it away. That's Kayla McBride trying to swipe the ball away from behind. Alperi Onar only has one steal. Feels like she's got more than that. Uzun, though, does have three. That's probably who I'm thinking of, the Uzun and Onar show when it comes to playing defense and coming up with steals. They are excellent. Oh, beautiful give and go. Look at that, Phoebus. And what you love more than anything about Zaragoza is, yeah, they're trailing, but they're playing the game the right way. When you see something like that, old school give and go, that shows they are locked in. Oh, Phoebus, oh boy, dangerous pass, and look who is lurking. Once again, Sevgi Uzun, and the ruling is that it went off of Zaragoza. So, Jefferson, who's checked into the game. Coughs it up. Less than 5 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Senorek takes it down low. And what's painful about these turnovers is they are leading to buckets. They're leading to points. Wow, another turnover. Stepped out of bounds was the call on Gulba. McBride goes between the legs. Over to Messemann. And there have been flashes or stretches during this game where we just see why Fenerbahce are the favorites. They just don't do anything wrong. They make it look so easy. And they stretch the game back to 17. Gervasini whips the pass, killed off to Atkinson, wide open three. Now McBride, who's yet, she had the first half scoring explosion, Kayla McBride. She hasn't scored yet here in the second. Sinurek bumped, pushed by Gulba. Messemann, just so smooth, fakes, drives, and then not even close. I mean, she's just so textbook. She puts it off the glass, it goes in, and as you ever seen, he turns it over once more. And this time they escape without being punished for it. Gervasini, tough pass. Geldof picks it up, does the right thing, getting to Jimeno. Atkinson drives and gets the contact with Sinurek. Nice touch, Atkinson. And the second is good. Messemann turns, contact by Holeshinska. Messemann doesn't drop this time for her. Now a chance to run. Atkinson. Atkinson, Holeshinska, open. Good box out. Pivets, Denali Pivets. There's the handoff, and the jumper from the elbow is not there for Hermosa. 1:45 remaining in this third quarter. Messemann again doesn't get the drop. Atkinson hesitates. Wonderful play. Hermosa finishes. Atkinson's had some nice game tonight. And that play cuts it back to a 15-point deficit. Atkinson definitely doesn't force the issue. She makes intelligent decisions.
Casademont turns, misses, and once again, look at Casademont Zaragoza just kind of hanging around. Good hustle back, knocking the ball out of bounds. Less than a minute to go in this third quarter. Hermosa takes the time, makes the first. And once again, back to a 14-point deficit, which is what we had at halftime. I'm not exactly sure what Anderson's deal is, but maybe there's some type of agreement or decision taken that she wasn't going to play, but only so many minutes, which goes back to when she made that foul and left. It was almost like she wanted to make the foul to leave the game. Atkinson, bounce pass. Great catch by Hermosa. Nerea Hermosa, and we've got an 11-point game. Very quietly, Zaragoza hanging around here. Final 12 seconds. Senurek for three. Atkinson. And one bounce pass too many. I believe Jimeno needed to shoot that. She did not. Ball goes out of bounds. But nevertheless, Casademont Zaragoza cut Fenerbahce's lead to 58-47 at the end of three. Try to get this deficit even closer. 58-47 now, so real chance for them to get to single digits, and the whistle blows and they get to the free throw line. Here's another look at it. 10-point game.
Now, a turnover. Phoebish stops and does not make it. Boy, that would have been interesting. She gets another chance. She puts it up and knocks it down. It's a 7-point game all of a sudden. Wow. It's almost as if Fenerbahce have been lulled to sleep a little bit here by this Zaragoza team. Here's the dump down low, Messamon, and they don't get a shot off. And Fenerbahce all out of sorts at this stage. And really the onus is on this Fenerbahce team to really snap out of it. And boy, that was an opportunity for Phoebus she wishes that she had back. Oh boy, another spurned opportunity. It was out of bounds. So Bursal Vardarli that was sitting over on the sidelines and watching the Fenerbahce legend and the Turkish legend. She understands that you do not want to mess around. You want to step on the throat of somebody when you get on top of them. And traveling the call on Howard. So 2 minutes into the fourth quarter, it's 7-point lead for Fenerbahce, but it does not feel safe at all. And Vega Jimeno drives in, misses. Oh boy, another opportunity goes by the wayside for Zaragoza. But the turnover, McBride trying to feed it into the low post, 2-on-1 break. And incredibly, Pivic, who's played well all game, misses the layup. And she collides with Jimeno. Look at this. What is she going to do? They give her the layup, and she misses it. Certainly was not by design. Fenerbahce yet to play well in the fourth quarter. Here, they get an open look from three. It rattles it in. That's more like it. Jimeno hands it off to Phoebus. Ortiz backs her way down, puts it up in the paint. Oh, look at that. Just knifing into the heart of that defense, seeing there was a path to the basket that was open. Cantor feels like his players have to figure this out. It's not going to help him to call a timeout. And this time, a foul's called. It's going to send Phoebus to the line. Phoebus bends the knees and makes the first. Germany International. 11 points, make it 12. Along with 2 rebounds, 2 assists, 5 of 8 from the floor.
Fenerbahce looking to lower the boom here to put this thing away. It's almost as if they've been playing with fire. But it looks like they've sharpened their focus a little bit here. Here, driving in, missing. Ortiz rebounds and runs, brings it up the floor. Passes back to Phoebus, who gets a down low to Atkinson. Look at that, and Aubert has to call timeout. Here's another look. And Atkinson cuts the deficit to So back to live action. The question is, can Fenerbahce slam the door shut coming out of the timeout? Messamon follows her own shot, misses, and another chance for Casademont. Five and a half minutes remaining. Ortiz, Phoebus down on the court, and that was an air ball. Hermosa got to do better than that in that situation. The drive, the whip to the corner, the three-pointer. Here's Messamon. Little runner. She banks it in right at the end. And that is the quality of the player, folks. Back up to a 10-point lead with 4.5 minutes remaining. Ortiz spins down to the baseline. Entry pass. Ortiz for three, no good. Rebound Fenerbahce, and they should be in no rush right now. They've got the chance to take some time. Well, they're going to drive in, and they're going to make it and make them pay as Phoebus picks up the foul, an and one coming. Well, that was, folks, you can only be impressed by this young woman right here. She has been terrific. And I don't think she gets nearly enough plaudits for what she does. Sevgi Uzun just getting it done. Doing a great job. Young Turkey International. She's got 10 points, 7 assists, 5 rebounds. I mean, that is outstanding. Onar as well has been terrific. A three-point shot, no good. McBride rebounds it, and with 3:40 remaining, the chances are starting to fade for Zaragoza, down 13. McBride to the corner again. Beautiful basketball once again from Fenerbahce, but this time the jump shot does not fall for Alperi Onar. Now Atkinson with Zaragoza. Pretty much, you'd have to say, now in a race against time. The clock is the enemy. They skip it, and Holyshenska missing it from deep. So the basketball will stay with Zaragoza. Camille Aubert enjoying her time over there. Looks like a natural, Aubert, I have to say. She's made some good decisions today. Here is Atkinson, and she's fouled as she drives by McBride. Aubert, 34 years of age, closing in on the win as the head coach today with Valerie Garnier away while following the passing away of her father. Here's Holyshenska taking it deep outside to Atkinson. That's more like it. Right at the end of the shot clock, and it's a 10-point game. Well, do they want to see if she got a three? See if her foot was on the line. You're not going to get it from that angle. Well, maybe not. I would be tempted to say no with this look here. It certainly looks like it's on the line, but could be harsh to take it away from. I'm not sure that's 100% conclusive. That's not going to change it, nor is that. From there, it looks like it's good. I don't think they're going to change it. I don't think there's enough evidence to overturn it. So indeed, it remains a three-pointer. 2.5 minutes remaining. Thing is not done. That three is just giving them a little bit of life. Kayla McBride, not messing around, takes the three. Chase it down, Uzun in the corner. McBride, another three, and she makes it. And what can you say? Frustrating sequence, but for Zaragoza. But if you don't get the offense, if you don't get the defensive rebound, you're liable to give that away. Here's Holyshenska for three. Good. And that keeps him right in it. And I like how the coach is letting him play. He's not calling timeouts. He's not disrupting the flow. Not only as a fan, but I think it's the right thing to do for his club. And here, look, they get the steal. And Ortiz drives in, hands it off to Holyshenska, and she makes it an 8-point game. And with that, Fenerbahce are going to call timeout. Ortiz, just such a crafty veteran, savvy And of course, she's going to make the right decision as she goes down the court and gets it to Holashinska, who now has 10 points. Oh, almost a steal. It's an 8-point difference. Casademont Zaragoza, that's what they would love to get, is a steal and go down and get an easy bucket. Easier said than done, but they have come up with some. Fenerbahce knows, look at that. That was the pass that almost went the other way. McBride, meanwhile, they're gonna launch it. The three, it's no good. Atkinson rebounds the miss, and she crosses midcourt, hands it off with 1:14 remaining. Atkinson, surely the go-to player here. She drives in, all wraps around to Geldof, misses the layup. Gonna go back up and score. She's stuck with it. And Fenerbahce being made to sweat it out here at the end. We're in the final minute. Their lead has been whittled down to 6 points. And what does this say about Zaragoza? They are a great team, not giving up the ghost, and making a run here to make this interesting at the end. Kayla McBride, her pass batted away, and I don't think she got it off in time, and Zaragoza with 37.7 seconds remaining. Have a chance, folks. Do not go away. Atkinson has been absolutely spectacular for Zaragoza, leading them in this second half. That last pass, another example of how complete a player she is. But this is a must-make. Will they look for a three, or will they go for the two, or take what's available? Holashinska behind the arc, nope. And Fenerbahce are going to come up and get the steal and commits the foul. And that was simply couldn't happen, the turnover in that situation. But Fenerbahce doing a good job defensively there. 5 second differential in the game clock. Nope, no turn off the shot clock. And Fenerbahce are gonna win it. Not hugely impressively in the second half. I mean, it's a weird game, isn't it? Fenerbahce get the win. That's what they came to do. But Zaragoza, I think, won some respect there at the end. And probably grew in self-belief, even though they didn't come back to win the game. They will be a team to be reckoned with. This is definitely another building block, even though their six-game winning streak is over. Impressive display. Fenerbahce win it 71-65 over Casademont Zaragoza. Thanks for watching, everybody.